Sôm mà chơi những cái chỗ. Ông nhập ra bậc cả một tô cái chấm nào cả vì phía xa đánh đầu. Chia một tô sôm. Cô vị tịch ca từ xã Bình Nhà năm mấy một tô cả tăng sôm nua chúng tôi chuẩn chập chào luôn chia. Sôm chơi.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Nunche, we were discussing the First Party Congress held in 1960. Can you tell us how many representatives of the party attended the First Congress that was held in 1960?
សនបាទនឹងមានសមាជិកប្រមាណអ្នកដែរតំណាងមកពីខាងណានៅក្នុងពេលនោះបាទ
សូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានពេលនោះឆ្នាំ 1960 នៅក្នុងសភាការ សម្ងាត់ ដូច្នោះការប្រជុំនេះជ្រើសរើសយកតែប្រធានភិក្ខុមកប្រជុំតាមខ្ញុំចាំចំនួនប្រហែលជា6-7នាក់
Previously, Mr. Nunche, when you had your discussion with Kem Nguyen, you indicated that there were a total of 10 to 15 representatives who were present. And I would also note that in the September 1977 revolutionary flag, there is a statement that there were, quote, 14 peasant representatives in charge of work in different rural areas, and 7 representatives of the cities, 21 delegates in all. For the record, I'm citing to document D243/2.1.12, English ERN 00486226, French ERN 00492811, and Khmer ERN 00063135-63136.
Does that refresh your recollection that there were closer to 20 total representatives
ដំណាងទាំងអស់នោះគឺប្រហែលជា 20នាក់ទេដែលចូលរួមនៅក្នុងសន្និបាតលើកទី1នោះបាទ
សូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានថាខ្ញុំមិនចង់ចាំទេ ព្រោះវាយូរឆ្នាំមកហើយ
In any event, you agree that it was a relatively small number of representatives who were invited to the First Congress. Is that correct? Am I correct that it was a relatively small number of people who were invited to the First Congress, whether it was 7 or 20? It was a small number only that were invited, correct?
Correct.
Yeah,
chom som su vinh pi chom ay sanibat ay ko rup lok prathean chom som su pi chao che ao chbam pi chom ru sanibat
Mr. Noonchay, we're talking about the Congress that was held in September 1960.
สมจมเรียบรูปประเทศเบอร์นิเยปีสันสันติบาทชนะมวยปอนผมมวยร้อยหกสิบจมนวลไปให้ผมมวยผมเปิลเนี่ยปนัง
Where was the Congress held? Was that Oksakun?
Some new town of the Oksakun, no rute.
Matrawai.
That was the same Oksakun who later became the Democratic Kapuchea representative to UNESCO in Paris. Is that correct?
UNESCO in Paris, Taman Rute.
Do you know if that was the same Oksakun that Khieu Samphan identified in his comments last month as the person who convinced him to join the Marxist circle in Paris? Is that the same person?
Mui maki nu Paris ta men te.
Som chum rup rup thien khom kdap men ban de. Khom men cham de.
How long was the Congress?
Som nu tha ta san bat nu pa prut te rye pel pan man dae yu pa na dae.
Som chum rup rup thien san bat nu pa bai ngay.
And is it correct that all the representatives stayed and slept at Oksakun's house for that entire 3 days and 3 night period? Is that correct?
Some chumri lok thien trau hai.
You've told us the people that you recall who were appointed to the Standing and Central Committees at the Congress. Can you tell us the procedure by which people were appointed to the Central and Standing Committee at the Congress? Was there voting? Or how was it that people were appointed to the committees?
สมจมเรียบนุปเทียนตามเข้มจำคือคางภูมิเพเกกิจเรือเรือเมาเอามาไปจุ่มมาสันมาสันจะบาดรวยเต้าสันจะบาดจะเรือเรือแทนตีด
Was the procedure for appointing people the same collective decision process that you described to us last month?
សមូហភាពវិនិច្ឆ័យកាលពីខែមុននោះឬទេ សូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានការរៀបចំចាត់តាំងនេះជាសមូហភាពតាំងតែសមូហភាពយុទ្ធសាស្ត្រ
I'd now like to ask you about some of the party lines that were approved at that first Congress. In your opening statement, you indicated that one of the matters that was discussed and decided at the 1960 Congress was an analysis of the true nature of Kampuchean society and how to eliminate feudalism. At this point, I'd like to show you a statement from the September 1977 Revolutionary Flag discussing that analysis of Kampuchean society by the 1960 Congress.
ដែលលើកឡើងក្នុងឆ្នាំ 1926 ខ្ញុំសូមអនុញ្ញាតដាក់បង្ហាញនៅលើអេក្រង់ឯកសារ D2439 French ERN 4862 29 41 Khmer ERN 63139 Khmer ERN 63139 អង្គជំរិតអនុញ្ញាតសូមអញ្ជើញ
មើលមិនឃើញទេសូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានគេមិនទាន់ដាក់ទេលោកនួនជាគេមិនទាន់ដាក់ទេចាំទៅចិត្តចាំឲ្យរៀបរយនេះមន្ត្រីច្បាប់ទៅមន្ត្រីតុលាការទៅតំរុំរួលដើម្បីឲ្យទៅមើលកុំព្យូទ័រគាត់ផង
Mr. Nunchia, there's two quotes from this revolutionary flag that I'll read to you and ask you about. The first one is on the screen now, marked with number 10, which is a statement that, quote, 85% of the population, the peasants, were in contradiction with the exploiting class that exploited them directly, the landowners. And then the second quote that I want to show, also from the September 77 flag, revolutionary flag, which is quote number 11, which appears at page English ERN 486230, French ERN 492816, and Khmer ERN 63140. The quote that I want to ask you about states as follows. Quote, this contradiction was a life and death contradiction. This was a profound contradiction in Kampuchean society, one which impacted 85% of the population. It was for this reason that the First Party Congress defined this contradiction as an antagonistic contradiction. The question I have for you, Mr. Nunchea, is whether you can explain to the chamber what was meant by the terms life and death contradiction and antagonistic contradiction.
ខ្វែងគំនិតគ្នាស្លាប់រស់នេះតើមានន័យដូចម្ដេចសូមជម្រាបលោកប្រធានតើតែយកឯកសារដើមនោះឲ្យខ្ញុំមើលឲ្យច្បាស់លោកនិយាយសួរអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំឆ្លើយមិនកើតពីព្រោះវាមិនច្បាស់
Muntray Tulaka, Tu Chit Nung Lok Nun Chia, Hai Rip Chom Ka Mong Han Nu Chum Noit Trong Asa Diamond Ku Rung Wung Po Krahom Nung Chum Chun God, and my God Mul.
Mr. President, the Khmer ERN page that you should be shown is 00063140.
ខ្ញុំទទួលនឹងបានទេតាំងតែយកឯកសារដើមបានវាច្បាស់នេះឯកសារដើមថាមាននៅនេះយកមកឲ្យខ្ញុំមើលមើល
Mr. President, I think we, on the last day of the session before, we gave our hard copy of that document to Mr. Nguyen Chea. I think he may have, his counsel may have given it back to us, so we're looking for it. But if I can ask him a more general question while we're looking for the hard copy in the interim. Thank you. The question that I'm asking you, Mr. Nguyen Chea, is in this document and numerous other party publications, there is the use of the term antagonistic or life and death contradiction in discussing the relationship between workers and peasants on one hand and the feudalist landowners on the other hand. I could give you six party publications where this term is used. So, aside from the specific document, can you explain to the court what the term antagonistic contradiction or life and death contradiction meant?
นี่ជាការអធិប្បាយរបស់លោកណាបងលោកខ្ញុំទទួលហើយទទួលទៀនឲ្យយកឯកសារនឹងមកឲ្យខ្ញុំមើលមើលវាមែនទេជាឯកសាររបស់ខ្ញុំទេជាឯកសាររបស់បកកុម្មុយនីសកម្ពុជាទេអានឹងបានខ្ញុំទទួលបាន ព្រះសម្បុរលោកព្រះរាជអញ្ញាអធិប្បាយតាមសម្ដីរបស់លោកព្រះរាជអញ្ញាមិននឹងនិយាយពាក្យសម្ដីណាមកអធិប្បាយមិនមែនខ្ញុំមើលងាយមើលថោកអីទេខ្ញុំគោរពព្រះរាជអញ្ញាខ្ញុំគោរពក៏ប៉ុន្តែអធិប្បាយវាមិនអស់សេចក្តីព្រោះការសរសេរនោះវាផ្សេងការអធិប្បាយវាផ្សេងការនិយាយវាផ្សេង Khiom to tool aikasa kupi ni bin ban de. Tante yo aikasa la mo bang khiom to tool mo. Oi chapa. Ani so tui tui mui.
ឥឡូវលោកកត់សម្គាល់លើខ្លឹមសារនៃសំណេរដែលបានបង្ហាញអញ្ញមិញមិញហ្នឹងលោកមានយោបល់កត់សម្គាល់យ៉ាងដូចម្តេចចំពោះបញ្ហាហ្នឹង សប្រញ្ញាបានដាក់អញ្ញមិញ ហើយមាននៅក្នុងរង្វង់គូក្រហមចំណុចទាំងអស់ហ្នឹង តើលោកមាន អធិប្បាយឬក៏មានការកត់សម្គាល់យ៉ាងដូចម្តេចលើបញ្ហាហ្នឹង
ខ្ញុំ ទទួល ហើយ ទទួល ទៀត ថា សូម យក ឯកសារ ដើម មិន យក ឯកសារ កូពី ទេ មិន ដឹង ជា កូពី ខុស ឬ ត្រូវ យ៉ាង ម៉េច ខ្ញុំ មិន ដឹង ទេ
អរគុណ លោក សប្រញ្ញា បន្ត សំណួរ ផ្សេង ទៀត
Do you deny, Mr. Nun Chea, that the party in describing the relationship between the peasants and the feudalist landowners used the term antagonistic or life and death contradiction? Have you ever heard the use of that term before?
Nhóm tôi tui hai tôi tui tiền lâu vô ai cả xa na mà người dễ dùng ở trong mơ mơ rư lâu như vậy luôn lâu
I'm asking you Mr. Nun Chea, have you ever heard the term life and death contradiction or antagonistic contradiction? Are those terms that you have ever heard before today?
Đại đệ lục thọ lư bịa bịch ni đại đệ pi môn nung.
Đại lục su pi môn nung pin cao na.
Have you ever heard those terms, Mr. Nunchea? Yes or no?
Khom kon na chang ban ta ta thlop ri kon mon thlop.
Khom thlop an aikasa phsei phsei khla. Tamno. Bo mien tamno ptei knong. Bo mien tamno patipa. Tamno slap tamno patipa nung kue tamno rovieng khmang. ហើយនឹងម្ចាស់ប្រទេសពួកខ្មាំងឈ្លានពៀនហើយនឹងប្រទេសដែលត្រូវឈ្លានពៀននេះហៅថាតំណោះបតិបៈតាមខ្ញុំយល់ហើយតំណោះផ្ទៃក្នុងនេះគឺតំណោះក្នុងប្រជាជនពីរឿងតិចតួចទេ
If I understand your statement, your testimony correctly, you're saying that there was two types of contradictions, internal contradictions and antagonistic contradictions. Is that correct? You just described, referred to something you called an internal contradiction, which you indicated was a relatively minor contradiction. Is that correct? And you indicated that there was another type of contradiction called an antagonistic contradiction, which is a more serious one that existed between the peasants and landowners. Is that also
correct? ហើយនឹងប្រទេសដែលត្រូវឈ្លានពានប្រជាជនដោយគ្នាមិនមែនជាដំណោះស្លាប់រស់ទេដោះស្រាយគ្នាដោយការចរចាគ្នាដោយការអីបានប្រឹក្សាគ្នាទៅប្រជុំពិភាក្សាគ្នាដោះស្រាយ
I'm not asking you about any particular documents now, Mr. Nguyen Chea. You were Deputy Secretary of the Party. You were present at the first Congress. I'm asking you a very simple, direct question. Did the party conclude that the contradiction between the peasants and the feudalist landowners was an antagonistic or life and death contradiction?
ខ្ញុំជម្រាបលោកប្រធានមិញលោកបរិយាញ្ញាមានប្រសាសន៍ថាតំណឹងរឿងកសិករនិងម្ចាស់ដីក្នុងឯកសារវាមាននិយាយល្អិតមិនមែនម្ចាស់ដីធម្មតាទេម្ចាស់ដីបរិវារបរទេសម្ចាស់ដីខូខើបើថាញីម្ចាស់ដីទៅទេនេះវាខុស មកគ្មានសំណោះម្ចាស់ដីនឹងកសិករសម្រួលគ្នាបានប៉ុន្តែបើម្ចាស់ដីនោះវាធ្វើបរិវារចាក់កពតបរិវារពួកឈ្លានពានអានឹងវាបំរើពួកឈ្លានពានហើយអានឹងហើយទៅជាសំណោះបតិបៈស្លាប់រស់បើលោកនិយាយមកកណាត់អញ្ចឹងបានខ្ញុំទៀមទាហើយទៀមទាទៀត
How was it that the party proposed to resolve contradictions that were life and death or antagonistic contradictions, Mr. Nguyen Chea? How were those contradictions to be resolved?
Tụi bây giờ tụi nó bài nào có nói thật ta cái đó sai tụi nó này đòi được biết nè.
Sống chung riêng lúc mà thiền. Cả đó sai tụi nó bắt đi bắt mà xên. Cả đó sai tụi nó bắt đi bắt mà xên. វាមិនដូចគ្នាទេការដោះស្រាយរឿងខ្មាំងហើយនឹងម្ចាស់ហើយនឹងប្រទេសដែលត្រូវឈ្លានពានវាផ្សេងដូច្នោះលោកសួរមកកណាត់អញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំឆ្លើយយ៉ាងម៉េចឲ្យច្បាស់ខ្ញុំឆ្លើយនឹងលោកសួរមកកណាត់
You just said that there were differences in the resolution, depending on whether it was an internal or antagonistic contradiction. Can you explain to the court what that difference was? How were internal contradictions resolved, and how were antagonistic contradictions resolved? I'm asking about a statement you just made a few minutes ago, Mr. Nunchea. You indicated that the resolution of the conflict depended on whether it was an internal contradiction or an antagonistic contradiction. I'm asking you to explain what you meant by that. You stated a few minutes ago that how a conflict was resolved depended on whether it was an internal contradiction or an antagonistic contradiction. I'm asking you to explain what you meant by that. How were these different contradictions resolved? Let me read to you two more documents issued by the party, and I'll give you one more chance to explain this, Mr. Nunchea. In a circular issued by the party entitled "Sharpen the Ideology of the Proletarian Class Until It Becomes Very Sharp and Strong," the following statement was made. Quote, "A minor mistake can lead to the antagonistic contradiction, in which situation we cannot work and live together." Continuing on, quote, "The conflict must be solved according to the situation and type, whether it is the internal conflict or the life and death one." That is a quote from case file number D366/7.1.56 at Khmer ERN 00442476, English ERN 00743812, and French ERN 00721105. refer you to the November 1976 Revolutionary Flag, which makes the following statement, quote, if they joined the revolution to embed themselves to attack the party, that is an antagonistic contradiction, and we take measures accordingly. That is from case file document D243/2.1.8. at Khmer ERN 00064999, English ERN 00455312, and French ERN 00459499. Is it correct, Mr. Nunchea, that an antagonistic or life and death contradiction is one in which you could no longer live and work together?
ពីព្រោះការសរសេរការនិយាយហ្នឹងវាមានអធិប្បាយពវីមិនមានតែខ្លីបែបហ្នឹងហើយយើងយល់ផ្សេងទេព្រោះមនុស្សយើង មនុស្ស 10 នាក់ ទេសនា ខុស នឹង 10 នាក់ លោក ទេសនា ផ្សេង ខ្ញុំ ទេសនា ផ្សេង លោក និយាយ តាម ទេសនា របស់ លោក ខ្ញុំ និយាយ តាម ទេសនា របស់ ខ្ញុំ ដូច្នោះ ឲ្យ វា ឯកភាព គ្នា យ៉ាង ម៉េច បាន បានជា ខ្ញុំ ទទូច ហើយ ទទូច ទៀត យក មក មើល យក ឯកសារ មក មើល ឲ្យ ខ្ញុំ អធិ ឲ្យ ខ្ញុំ ពិនិត្យ ពិចារណា មើល ថា តើ ជា ឯកសារ របស់ ខ្ញុំ មែន ឬ មិន មែន
All right, Mr. Nunchea, I'll move on to another party line to ask you about. In your opening statement, you described how the party adopted a strategic line to start from the outskirt areas and work gradually towards the urban areas. And in your 1998 discussion with Kem Nguyen, you stated that the party had to be built using the countryside as a support base and the city as the fuse. What did you mean by that? We've discussed him a number of times, Mr. Nunchea. You had what you called a chit-chat with a Mr. Kem Nguyen in 1998. Do you recall stating that the party needed to use the countryside as a support base and the city as a fuse? Do you recall making that statement?
តើលោកមានចាំថាលោកបានថ្លែងចំណុចនេះឡើងទេ
ខ្ញុំសូមបញ្ជាក់ខឹមងុនឬអ្នកណា
Yes, that is the person I'm talking about, Mr. Nunchea.
បាទគឺឈ្មោះនេះហើយឈ្មោះខឹមងុននេះហើយដែលខ្ញុំកំពុងតែនិយាយប៉ុន្តែខ្ញុំសួរអំពីសេចក្តីថ្លែងការណ៍របស់លោកអំពីសម្ដីរបស់លោក
តាមមេគា អានេះខ្ញុំទៅធ្លាប់ទៅនិយាយខាងមេគាវិញតែដដែលដដែល ដូចនោះខ្ញុំមិននិយាយទេ
Mr. Nunchea, what is the reason that the party determined in 1960 to use the countryside as its base rather than the cities?
ជាសំខាន់ពីព្រោះប្រជាជននៅចុងកាត់មាត់ញោកក្រីក្រលំបាកវេទនាតោកយ៉ាដូច្នោះត្រូវឲ្យប្រជាជនចុងកាត់មាត់ញោកញាក់រលឹកចេះធ្វើរបបដាំដុះរស់ទទួលទានដូច្នោះត្រូវកែប្រែជីវភាព ត្រូវកែប្រែពីចងជន់របត់ចងកាត់មាត់ញោកមកវិញមកមុនពីព្រោះនៅទីក្រុងឬនៅទីប្រជុំជនគេមានលមមទទួលទានហើយឯនៅចងកាត់មាត់ញោកណ៎ក្រីក្រណាស់រោគអញ្ជើញទៅមើលចុះនៅរលាក់កងជើងនៅអូរ៉ាល់នៅស្អីស្អីនោះ ក្រនំបាក់វេទនារហេមរហាមអ្នកណាយកចិត្តកាលនោះអ្នកណាយកចិត្តទុកដាក់ជួយគ្មានទេរត់ទៅខោអាវស្លៀកពាក់គ្មានផងដូច្នោះត្រូវចាប់ផ្ដើមធ្វើការងារពន្យល់អធិប្បាយឃោសនាឲ្យប្រជាជនចងកាត់ញាក់មាត់ញោកយល់បណ្ដាបណ្ដាមក
And was another reason the party selected the countryside as its base? Because it determined that the enemies of the party were located primarily in the cities.
ហេតុផលដូចខ្ញុំសូមគោរពលោកប្រធានហេតុផលដែលយកជនបទចុងកាត់មាត់ញោកធ្វើជាមូលដ្ឋានបង្អែកពីព្រោះដើម្បីឲ្យក្មួយគ្មានខ្មាំងខ្មាំងទៅមិនដល់ទេចុងកាត់មាត់ញោកនោះវានៅទីប្រជុំជនទេ ដូច្នោះក៏ដំណើរការស្រួលឲ្យការតស៊ូពីរដូចខ្ញុំជម្រាបយើងប្រជាជនក្រីក្រលំបាកវេទនាណាដូច្នោះធ្វើឲ្យប្រជាជនមានហូបមានចុកមានស្លៀកមានពាក់មុនគេហើយចេះតែធ្វើមកបណ្ដើបណ្ដើមក
Let me read to you a statement from the September 1977 Revolutionary Flag, which stated as follows, quote, "Our operational line was that the countryside was the support base. Why did we take the countryside as the base, and why did we not take the cities as a support base? The cities could not be used as a support base. Though the population there was large, the cities were small, the enemy was everywhere there. the assembly, the courts, the prisons, the police, and the soldiers were all there. The networks of the enemy's repressive apparatus were concentrated there. This is from document D243/2.1.12 at Khmer ERN 000-63150. English ERN 00486238 and French ERN 492826. Mr. Nunchea, was this a correct statement of why the party chose the countryside as its support base rather than the cities?
ដោយជខ្ញុំនិយាយថាសូមឲ្យលោកយកឯកសារមកឲ្យខ្ញុំមើលមកឲ្យខ្ញុំឃើញភ្នែកខ្ញុំមើលបានខ្ញុំឆ្លើយបាន
Mr. Nunchea, I can show you a copy of this page if you will answer the question. But again, if you are asking us to submit the originals, the court has already ruled on that, and we cannot do that. So if I show you a copy of this quote, will you answer my question?
ខ្ញុំក្តាប់នៅសំណូមពររបស់តុលាការគឺ 1 ស្វែងរកការពិត 2 រយុត្តិធម៌នេះដែលខ្ញុំស្ដាប់លោកប្រធានប្រកាសទិសកោតឡើងនៃតុលាការនេះដូច្នោះតើមានឲ្យច្បាស់លាស់មក បើក្រំតែថានិយាយមកតទេអញ្ចឹងវាមិនវាខុសអំពីពលដៅដែលចង់រកការស្វែងរកការពិតចង់រកយុត្តិធម៌ចុះបើមិនយល់មកឲ្យមើលទៅមិនដឹងអ្នកណាមិនដឹងអ្នកណាសរសេរយុត្តិធម៌ឬមិនយុត្តិធម៌អ្នកណាទៅសរសេរ ខ្ញុំ ក៏ ចង់ ឲ្យ តុលាការ នេះ រត់ ស្វែង រក ការ ពិត ដែរ ឲ្យ ស្វែង រក ការ ពិត មាន ប្រយោជន៍ និង យុត្តិធម៌ សម្រាប់ យុវជន ចំនួន ក្រោយ នេះ ដើម្បី រៀន សូត្រ ដក ពិសោធន៍
Mr. Nunchea, we are happy to show you the page and simply ask you to read it and answer whether or not it is a correct statement of party policy. So why don't we show, put up on the screen, if we could, Mr. President, this page, which is Khmer ERN 00-63150. It is our quote number 20. We can also give you a hard copy of that, Mr. Nunchea. And my question is simply whether this statement is a correct statement of party policy. Are you willing to answer that question based on a copy of the document rather than the original?
បើលោកបង្ហាញឯកសារដើមឲ្យខ្ញុំឲ្យបើពិតជាឯកសារដើមរបស់ខ្ញុំមែនខ្ញុំទទួលខ្ញុំសូមគោរពលោកប្រធានប៉ុន្តែលោកកណ្ដានិយាយទៅទេគ្មានឯកសារយោបញ្ជាក់គ្មានភស្តុតាងយោបញ្ជាក់ខ្ញុំទទួលយ៉ាងម៉េចបាន
Mm-hmm. Mr. President, why don't we try this one more time to show the witness the relevant page and see whether he'll answer. Again, it's Khmer ERN 0063150. If we could put that on the screen.
Look, Nunchia, on Chum Chum Reh, Ban Sam Raj Ruj Hai, Ka Bi Prak Minh, Kham Puh Ai Kha Sa, Electronic, Dail Pra Pra, Nuk Nong Sonom Rung Kadai Ni. Ai Kha Sa Teng Oh Ni, on Chum Reh, Chat Tuk Ki Ai Kha Sa, Kho Tang, Da Nui Chum Puh Muk on Chum Reh, Sam Raj Phi Ki Đanh Daol. ដោយហេតុប្រព័ន្ធនៃការប្រើប្រាស់នៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងនៅទីនេះគឺប្រើប្រាស់ប្រព័ន្ធឯកសារអេឡិចត្រូនិកហើយចាប់តាំងពីមុនពេលនឹងរហូតដល់ពេលសហជក្រមស៊ើបសួរស៊ើបអង្កេតបានចេញដោយការដំណោះស្រាយមិនមានមេធាវីឬភាគីណាមួយ đừng mua cặp hiệp cách làm nào cả thì thi om pi profit ai cả xa đài bàn đặt nơi chụp mục ông chụp rẻ này bên đi đài bàn bằng hai cục cục kia cục phía kia chẳng o chẳng ông chụp rẻ tam cảnh chọn tu rồi tu đài dương prapra tăng bị đam tí đã hụt một tí ni chẳng ông chụp rẻ bàn sầm rách rồi hơi đời xa rừng cái đấy ní miền ai cái xa thung thình hơi tại miền tây một chút bài prapra tam propon ai cái xa electronic cục rồng đại ai cái xa đại electronic bên nó từ ai cục rồng sông nông rừng ní bàn là o trầm trớ hay chập là ha nước nông cá thưa nông cá đỏ trái bảy nhà há ở bàn chập là ha nước toàn bì bì lì đối với này nơi khán ông ai cả xa trong phố mốc đại bản đại đời xã về nhà ni sông lục nôn chia bị nứt an nơi ai cả xa ni rồi hơi lục ao bản tranh nơi mà tệ giữa bờ trong bên pà nhà này khâm xa này ai cả xa đại bản đại trong phố mốc ni thà tớ lục miền mà tệ dụng bó dạng đây mà đây, tệ lưu khlâm xa, rồi bảo vi. Dương kết tha, à vây à vây, đại lục ban chú bật tia, miễn bọt vì sao chú bật tia, nên không dì vật đó bảo lục. Nâng khlâm xa, nơi ai cả xa, đại miên, đòi khám miên, phía kỳ na mùi, đừng mô cập hiệp, cách nhầm nào ca này tệ vị thi, nơi không lòng phí đá, chắc bạp, cầm nọt sật ao y nu. Cứ miên nây tha, chi ai cả xa, phá lờ ca, đại đặng mộc, đánh đáo bàn hơi chẳng này ai khlâm xá cứ chỉ bắt sau đại lục bàn chú bật tia nơi khăn ông chỉ vật to su đó bật lục tại lục ai an bàn tí bà lục an mình bàn tí cứ ông chẳng rẻ nâng chặt cả làm chí ai an nơi khlâm xá nấy ai cả xá để đạn đời xã bì nhà ni đầm bây ở dư là bị khlâm xá đó bảo vi tại lúc ai thưa các cọt thẩm quan lưu bánh hà này bàn tí
nó có quân rụp thiên đại bàn miền mà tệ giang chịa cho ba đồng bấy ruột cà pít nâng dứt thì thô. Tại nhóm, ôi nhóm chưa tục chết lê tổ la ca. Mà rồi phía rồi bàn đấy. Bơ mình ôi nhóm mơ ai cả xa, ai cả xa pít. Ôi nhóm khơi phòng mơ. Nhóm cổ rốt tổ la ca ấy. ព្រះតឡាការជាពូជនីយសស្ថានហើយបុគ្គលក្នុងតឡាការជាពូជនីយបុគ្គលដែលខ្ញុំគោរពប៉ុន្តែខ្ញុំទទួលយ៉ាងទទួលទៀតបើទទួលតាំងពីព្រឹករហូតដល់ថ្ងៃនេះរហូតដល់ស្មើនេះថាយកឯកសារមកឲ្យខ្ញុំមើលមើលហើយដាក់នេះមើលមើលមិនឃើញទេហើយឯកសារហ្នឹង ខ្ញុំ មើល មិញ ឃើញ អសរ ទូច ទូច មួយ នេះ សូម គោរព លោក ប្រធាន សូម អរគុណ លោក ប្រធាន ជា អណែក
សូម ជួយ មេធាវី
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Your Honor. I think the position of my client is very clear. He's challenging the authenticity of the digitally produced documents. He's willing to look at the original documents to assess their authenticity. And to be absolutely clear, we have many times objected to the admission of these documents in this trial. We've always said that the authenticity has to be established. And I understand that the documents have been admitted with your decision this morning to the trial, but that doesn't mean that they are authentic. In order to be used as evidence, the authenticity has to be established. I understand there's going to be a debate next week. Maybe you can postpone this discussion until next week. When this is going to be put on the agenda. And if it's not on the agenda, we can put it on the agenda. Thank you.
មានភិក្ខុណាចង់លើកឡើងអំពីបញ្ហានេះដែរឬទេ សូមអញ្ជើញមក
The Learner Council has it correct. I think next week is going to decide to discuss the admissibility of documents. We would be asking Your Honours to advise Mr. Nguyen Chia that his failure to answer questions in relation to copies of the documents that may in fact place less weight on his evidence at the end of the case. That's what we will be submitting at the end of the case. In relation to whether or not copies of original documents are required in order for copies to be admissible, Your Honours have correctly stated that under international criminal law at the other tribunals, originals are not required to be presented unless there is a significant doubt as to their authenticity. At this stage, Your Honours, as you know, the defence has not put forward prior to the accused raising it any specific indicators that this document or other documents the prosecution have put forward are in fact the copies are not in fact authentic copies. So we would ask that it is not required that originals be brought to this court. We've provided in our filings international jurisprudence to that effect that originals are not required. And one of the reasons for that, of course, is that the hearing can come to a standstill if every accused said, I will not comment on a document unless the original is brought forward. There's got to be a reasonable and significant basis to assume that the copy that's been shown is in fact not a copy of the original. Just the fact that the accused states, I need to see the copy, I need to see the original, that cannot be a reason to make the court produce those documents because then the trial will be brought to a standstill. As your honours are aware, on the case file there are about 12,000 documents, and the prosecution has put forward about 4,500 for the first phase of this case. If the accused has the right to bring forward every original of those 4,500 documents without providing the court a reasonable basis for that, other than I would just like to see the original. The case law of international tribunals does not support that, and they don't support it because it would bring the trial to a standstill and there would not be expeditious justice. The defence have to provide a far more reasoned and comprehensive argument about why this document and other documents need to be brought forward. Your Honours have given the defence, the new and chair of the defence, the opportunity to do that. They have failed to do that in their written pleadings. Your Honour has seen that. And simply at the whim of an accused that every original be brought to the court, that doesn't further the interests of justice. It only lengthens the process to a point that the trial would not be expeditious. So we reject the defence objection that originals are required to be brought forward unless there is a significant argument made as to the document not being what it purports to be, namely a copy of the original. And the defence nor the accused have not done that. And so we would ask them just to proceed on the basis of copies. And if the accused decides not to answer questions on the basis of those copies, then we will be submitting to Your Honours at the end of the case that less weight be placed on the accused evidence on the particular issues which he doesn't decide to comment on, bearing in mind he has taken the stand and has decided to give evidence. Thank you.
Good morning, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honors, and good morning to everyone in and around the courtroom. A couple of points. The international co-prosecutor fails to note that normally in the international tribunals there is some sort of a procedure as to where the documents came from. So while they may not necessarily require the original documents to be placed before each witness, there is some sort of a custodian who would come and testify, or they would do it by way of a motion. We have filed submissions indicating that we wish the authenticity of documents to be established before being used. It was a general submission, and granted, it would appear that we will get to that next week, but I think the onus is on the prosecution to establish where these documents came from and when they were copied, how were they copied, and so on. So that's my first point. The second point that I have, which goes to the testimony and the manner in which the evidence is being taken today, it started off with, and I apologize for being late, but as I walked in, the question that was being posed was with respect to the 1960 Congress. Then the prosecutor, that is, began to ask a general question about policy, never eliciting from Mr. Nunchia what exactly was discussed to get his evidence, what, if any, policies were set forth, but rather, he then jumps forward some 17 years, refers to a document, and then wants to validate what's in the document in order to establish that back in 1960, there were policies set in place. And so I would submit, Your Honors, that this is a waste of time. The prosecution has Mr. Nunchia, and they should simply ask him What was discussed during that three-day period in 1960? What policies, if any, were discussed? What programs were set in place? I think that should be the beginning. And then if he wishes to impeach Mr. Nguyen Chia with some document, then he can go ahead and do so. But in my opinion, I don't think it's fair to sort of mention 1960 and then somehow talk about policies in order to later on argue that in 1960 certain policies were set in place because something was written someplace. Because we have, during that 17-year period, there is an entire dynamic. The situation is very fluid, and I don't think that the sort of questioning that is being posed, especially the leading nature of them, gets us anywhere. At least it doesn't get us any closer to the truth. And that, I think, is why we are here. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Very briefly,
the prosecutor suggested that my client has not given specific, has not raised specific objections against the documents which were shown to him today. He has said about the revolutionary flag, several things. Suggest that these documents, these copies, are not copies of an original document or authentic document. He has said that as far as he remembers, the revolutionary flag pre-1975 was hand-written. He also said that the revolutionary flag was replaced by the red flag after 1975. The red flag was a printed document. He looked at the printed copy of the digital version of the document, and he said the letters were too small. I remember That's up to the prosecutor now to show that these documents are authentic, and part of this showing is also that they have to prove the chain of custody. It's really not up to us to prove that. It's up to the prosecutor. We cannot prove that. ការថតចម្លងនេះវាមានភាពត្រឹមត្រូវពិតប្រាកដបង្ហាញពីភាពដើមនៃឯកសារមិនមែនសំដៅទៅលើការកូពីចម្លងទេបាទការកូពីចម្លងវាជាមធ្យោបាយមួយសម្រាប់ឲ្យយើងងាយស្រួលក្នុងការធ្វើការដោយលោកប្រធានមានប្រសាសន៍ថាយើងប្រើប្រព័ន្ធអេឡិចត្រូនិកដូច្នេះការកូពីវាអាចប្រើបាននៅក្នុងតុលាការយើងនេះដោយសារឯកសារច្រើនប៉ុន្តែអ្វីដែលជាបញ្ហាសំខាន់នោះគឺថាតើការកូពីការថតចម្លងនេះវាមានភាពត្រឹមត្រូវពិតប្រាកដបង្ហាញពីភាពដើមនោះបានក្នុងកម្រិតណ
trâm tới đại biểu nào nú có mình toàn ban bằng hai đại đôi lục mê TV mày khởi khăn và ban chấm riệp bằng bài mày ní với dương ắt ban bằng hai ta nẹt đại rẻ xa túc ai cả xa nẹt đại thưa cả thọ chấm lón ban thưa trâm tới đại biểu nào để ai ơi tu la ca dục bằng thưa cả định đạo bản chạy tôn tận năng
Some non poor about look don't cheer. They got looked high, got murmur and curling, a salt toad, some yule tiny, via cheer, pine half pipe rule, nay, check a take copy, got tap banner, or tea hall, no pale dial copy, though, we have been room, been from reading, though, to our son with papal, toy tom, but it's name but show by, but since you young, I'd behind her, I got a sack of pee, leave a drum dry high, which by high, look at damn high, and young. Thưa mấy, đam mê phần đất từ lời khám xa này ăn quán hệ bán. Bà lục nguồn chia quạt chá quạt bơ mình khơi nhưng ai ai miền nhẹ chùm nuối án, ai ai lục mê thư vi rồi bỏ quạt bà có bán, có làm chi quạt bán. Nhưng ai thưa cả phần đất từ lời khám xa này bán này bà xong hỏi cùng.
Hỏi cùng, xong chơi mê thư vi đồng nó múc.
Oui, Monsieur le Président, en très rapidement pour donner l'avis des parties civiles, nous soutenons la position qui a été exposée par les procureurs il y a quelques moments sur ce problème des documents et nous faisons observer que ces documents ont été déposés pendant la période de l'instruction, qui est une période justement qui permet des opportunités de discuter la véracité de ces documents et nous constatons qu'ils ont été numérisés pendant l'instruction et que toutes les parties ont eu connaissance des versions numérisées pendant l'instruction. Ce sont des documents qui sont dans le fait depuis plusieurs mois, voire plusieurs années, sous cette forme numérisée. Monsieur le
Président, pour le Vatican de Sabrina, on a dit, je suis venu, je suis venu, je suis venu,
briefly, Your Honour, we agree with the Council that documents have to have a minimum level of authenticity, and that's the test in international law. There must be some indicators that would show that the document is authentic and the prosecution's reasons for that. And that is what the hearing is about next week. Of course, this is next week's hearing, this week. Just to briefly respond, as far as Nguyen Chia's argument or position that these documents or this document today is not in fact a copy of an authentic document, my learned friend has put forward that he's raised some doubt, but in fact there is no doubt in relation to this document because this document, this revolutionary flag, was produced after 1975 and he has given testimony today that the documents produced after 1975 were in fact printed and this document was printed. So the very fact that he states that revolutionary flags or red flags prior to 1975 were in handwriting is not really the issue, because the document that was produced to him today was in fact dated after 75, which confirms the authenticity of the document rather than throws it in doubt. The fact that it's not, he said it was in red, it's clear it's a black and white copy. That doesn't throw the authenticity in doubt. The fact that the letters are too small, that's really just a case of visibility of the document. Of course, Your Honours, the prosecution will not be putting documents forward that cannot be read by Your Honours, the defence, the prosecution, because that would be useless, it would be unreliable. If the defence or if Mr. Nguyen Chia, and it's understandable, needs a larger version to look at something, to comment on it, of course that can be done on the computer screen. But we would disagree that Mr. Nguyen Chia has thrown in doubt the authenticity of this document today. More so, we would say that he's more than that confirmed it. In relation to the method of questioning, how an accused or a witness should be questioned, I think within reasonable parameters, that should be the prerogative of the party. As long as the questions are clear and not confusing and are simple, the idea of putting a document in 1977 or after 1975 to be accused, which states what the fundamental party lines were in 1960, is clearly relevant to this section of the case, the historical background, particularly when the accused in some instances is finding it difficult to remember.
it's quite appropriate to prod and accuse memory in relation to documents, even if they were produced after 1975, when they relate specifically to what was agreed on in 1960 at the first meeting, and that was specifically stated in the document. So it is appropriate, Your Honours, to put that questioning to the accused. If there was a concern, perhaps that should have been raised earlier, but I would suggest that was highly appropriate questioning, particularly when an accused is perhaps forgetful on certain areas.
Thank you.
ព្រឹកមិញលោកប្រធានបានអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យលោកអេងសេរីបានចូលរួមសវនាការពីចម្ងាយប្រកហើយដោយសារថាស្ថានភាពសុខភាពគាត់មិនទាន់បានធម្មតាធូរស្រាលឡើងវិញខ្ញុំបានសូមអនុញ្ញាតលោកប្រធានមេត្តាអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យគាត់បន្តចូលរួមសវនាការពីចម្ងាយហើយដោយព្រឹកមិញតទៀតសម្រាប់ពេលល្ងាចនេះហើយពាក្យសូមសម្រាប់រយៈពេលមួយថ្ងៃនឹងធ្វើបែបនេះ
យើងខ្ញុំបានដាក់ស្នើជូនមកតុលាការហើយសូមអរគុណអនុញ្ញាតតាមការស្នើសុំឥឡូវដល់ពេលសម្រាកហើយដែលជិតកន្លះម៉ោងហើយលើដូចនេះអង្គជំរះប្រកាសសម្រាកដើម្បីពិសារថ្ងៃត្រង់ចាប់ពីពេលនេះទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង 1:30នាទីរសៀលនេះសូមអញ្ជើញចូលវិញដើម្បីបន្តសម្ដែងការអនុរិយមន្ត្រីឃុំឃាំងនាំជូនចប់ចោតទៅ ការបន្ទុករងចាំខាងក្រោមហើយឲ្យនាំគាត់ពីរូបនេះមកកាន់សាលសម្ដែងការវិញនៅរាជធានីបានមុនម៉ោង 1:30 នាទីជាកំណត់សូមសម្រាកចុះ